Welcome to Recap King. In this video, we will explain Restart the Earth. This movie tells the story of the future where predatory plants rule over the whole Earth. A group of soldiers is trying to destroy the plants and restore the Earth. Will their efforts be successful? Let's find out in Restart the Earth. Restart the Earth begins by showing a little girl who is crying, looking for her parents in the middle of a crumbling city. People seem to be running around her, saving themselves. Plants begin to mutate and grow very quickly and become very large. Even the roots can destroy buildings and vehicles due to the abnormal growth. Not only that, some plants also look like giant monsters that often attack humans. It didn't take long for the abnormal plants to destroy the entire city, and their growth didn't stop there either. The plants' roots spread from one city to another, increasingly spreading from one country to another, until finally nearly 80% of the Earth's surface was covered with vines that continued to grow abnormally and threaten the survival of humankind. 2 years later, after an abnormal plant disaster strikes, a man named Hao and his daughter, Yuan, must survive without the help of others because they were left behind when the government evacuated the town's residents. One day, when Yuan found a puppy in the forest, her father appeared and immediately scolded her because she left without him knowing. Hao then tried to observe the surroundings just in case. However, Yuan had already run into the middle of the forest to chase the puppy without her father realizing it. Hao then looked for his daughter's whereabouts and how surprised he was when he found the child in a place where there were predatory plants sucking nutrients from the human body. In horror, Hao tries to save his daughter, who the predatory plants are now targeting. Despite having to struggle to escape and jump over the abyss, Hao and Yuan managed to survive the pursuit of predatory plants that tried to prey on them. These predatory plants are known to grow very quickly and photosynthesize in the dark. Arriving at the hideout, Hao had his daughter put on a GPS watch linked to his GPS device, which could track Yuan's whereabouts in case she disappeared again. After that, Hao asked Yuan to sleep and he went on to do one of his routines, which was to radio for help, which didn't seem as work as before. While listening to the radio, Hao suddenly fell asleep and dreamed about himself and Yuan and his wife going on vacation just before the crop disaster occurred. Hao's wife named Yan is a scientist working on research with other scientists to find solutions to maintain the sustainability of forests to increasingly threatened by rampant illegal logging. While they were in the car, Yan received a video call from her colleague who reported that one of their experimental plants had mutated and was growing very fast and abnormally. And at the same time, she saw the people in the city start running to save themselves from the attack of plants that move very fast and grow rapidly. She then asked her husband to take her to the office to salvage important files and research samples that she believed could tackle the plant disaster. Yan then told her husband that something had gone wrong in the experiment she and her colleagues were working on before the disaster. She assumes that the experimental plant has its own consciousness, where the plant automatically assumes that living things other than plants are a source of food. That is the reason why these predatory plants chase humans and prey on them. When Yan and her family were about to leave, the predatory plant suddenly appeared from within the wall and grabbed her. Hao was forced to give up his wife because at the same time, Yuan was also being pulled by another predatory plant and Yan asked Hao to save their daughter. Hao then woke up from the nightmare after hearing the screams of Yuan who had fallen into the ground and was being dragged by the predatory plant somewhere. He tries to track Yuan's whereabouts using a GPS device and finds the GPS signal from Yuan's watch being in an abandoned building. Hao found Yuan's watch lying not far from the corpse of a person who was covered with plants all over his body. Before long, he managed to find his daughter who was entangled by the roots of a predatory plant. Hao tried to save his daughter by fighting the predatory plants and trying to break the window so that sunlight could enter the place. The predatory plants would become weak when exposed to sunlight. He manages to free his daughter, but now it's his turn to be the target of the predatory plant. When the predatory plant was about to kill him, a female soldier immediately slashed the plant's roots with her sword and saved Hao. Behind the woman, several other soldiers also came to eradicate the predatory plants with bursts of fire and a barrage of bullets. However, as the predatory plants arrived, they eventually activated a special device that emits ultraviolet light, causing the plants to weaken instantly. Hao thanked her for saving his life. He also curious about what the soldiers were doing in that place. A female soldier named Li Mo then explained that they were a special force formed by a joint command worldwide. They went on to reveal that for the past 3 years, scientists at the Joint Command Center had been monitoring that the mutated plant had formed a massive root network at a depth of 10.3 kilometers underground. Scientists have also predicted that there will be a catastrophe, namely a green wave storm that will destroy the remaining humanity in just an instant. Based on the biological activity of these predatory plant roots, scientists estimate that they only have 2 days before the plant storm hits and destroys the world. For this reason, the Joint Command Center formed 141 special forces worldwide who were tasked with implanting a capsule called N11 malate hydrazide agentia. The capsule served to calm the ferocious nature of the predatory plant and turn all the mutated plants back to normal like plants in the past. Special forces must plant the device at certain points that are believed to be the center points of predatory plants. Howe and the soldiers didn't realize that their presence had attracted the attention of other predatory plants, which then attacked them from underground. Howe, Limo, Yuan and a soldier who is also a mechanic expert fell and was separated from the other soldiers who started shooting at the predatory plants with their weapons. Due to this incident, Howe realized that the predatory plants could not see, but was very sensitive to sound. He then asked his daughter and the other soldiers to move carefully to avoid the plant monster's attack. However, Yuan seemed to be too frightened and didn't pay attention to her steps when the plant monster was so close to her. The little girl accidentally dropped something which immediately drew the plant monster's attention towards her. When the plant monster was about to attack Yuan, the mechanic closest to her immediately shot at the plant monster and sacrificed himself by blowing himself up as the predatory plant wrapped around his body. The explosion then sent Yuan, Howe and Limo out of the building. But the three of them managed to survive thanks to the sacrifice of the mechanic. The other soldiers who knew the mechanic had died looked sad and pessimistic because they had lost the only mechanic on the team. The squad leader, who learned about Howe's abilities when repairing something in the building, then asked him to join their team. At first, Howe refused because he thought the mission was very dangerous for Yuan. However, Yuan manages to convince her father that the mission is a noble mission where they have a chance to save the world and humanity. Finally, Howe and Yuan joined the special forces. On the way, one of the soldiers detected the appearance of a green wave storm that was coming sooner than expected. Shortly after, the ground they were standing on shook violently and began to split apart. In a matter of minutes, the predatory plants doubled in size and started destroying all the buildings around them. The soldiers tried to contact the command center to inform them of the emergence of a faster crop storm, but the lines of communication were cut off. Howe, Yuan and the soldiers then tried to save themselves by taking cover in a minibus. However, one of the soldiers carrying the N11 capsule was left behind and fell into a hole in the ground. Although in the end the soldier didn't survive because the plant monster killed him instantly, he managed to throw the box containing the N11 capsule in time so the other soldiers could continue their mission. Everyone had boarded the minibus just before the green wave hurricane hit. The bus they were traveling in was thrown very far until it finally got stuck in a building. After that incident, everyone seemed very frustrated for their survival because the green wave hurricane that had just occurred was a hurricane of a small scale but had such destructive power that it destroyed an entire city. They couldn't imagine what would happen if they failed their mission and a large-scale green wave storm did occur. When the army leader looked desperate, Yuan tried to encourage him and the man's fighting spirit was revived. Since their communication device wasn't working, Howe suggested that they head to the next building. They can use the signal transmitter on the roof of the building to communicate with the Joint Command Center. They then decided to use a crane bridge that spanned a height to reach the building faster. However, when they were about to cross, suddenly the building near them collapsed. Although the ruins of the building did not hit them, the resulting blast of air was so strong that it knocked Yuan from a height. Luckily, the squad leader immediately saved Yuan by hanging from a rope. Because the load was too heavy, the rope eroded due to friction with the sharp iron. The army leader then sacrificed himself by jumping down so that Yuan could hold onto the rope alone. After the incident, the soldiers then entered the building and headed to the communication room with Howe and Yuan. Howe then used his abilities to fix the electrical system in the communications room so the soldiers could contact the command center. After the communication was connected, the soldiers immediately reported about a small-scale green wave storm hitting them. Based on this information, scientists at the Joint Command Center concluded that they had less than 4 hours to complete the mission before the next green wave storm occurred. Hearing this prediction, the world leaders at the Joint Command Center immediately felt pessimistic and intended to cancel the mission. However, Howe told them not to give up and make the best of the opportunity they had. After hearing Howe's words, the leaders at the Joint Command Center then gave the choice of the special forces who were fighting around the world to continue their mission or surrender to fate. Long story short, Howe, Yuan and the soldiers arrived at a place to implant the N11 malate hydrazide agentia capsule at a depth of 10.3 kilometers. They will use a giant drilling machine to reach the desired depth. After turning on all the systems in place, the machine that launched the N11 capsule was stuck in the middle of the road because the layer of soil underneath had been covered by very thick plant roots. On the other hand, special forces from other countries tried to destroy the roots of the predatory plants with missiles fired in the sea, but these efforts were also unsuccessful. When Howe and the soldiers felt pessimistic about continuing the mission because they thought it would fail, suddenly there was a great shock along with a rumbling sound from a nearby volcanic eruption. It turned out that the giant drilling tools were used to control the volume of volcanic lava so that it would not spill over into residential areas. Seeing this, Howe was optimistic again and suggested that they blow up the lava regulator so that hot lava could spill out and scorch the very thick plant roots. With his skills, Howe managed to create a time bomb that he would use to destroy the device. Howe would activate a time bomb at a certain depth, while Limo and another soldier were in charge of protecting him. On the way, the three of them were blocked by a predatory plant that had nested there and attacked them mercilessly. The soldiers who came with Howe and Limo then put up the front body to protect them both and were willing to sacrifice their lives for the mission's success. After successfully avoiding the plant monster attack, Limo and Howe then continued their journey. However, when he reached his destination, Howe locked himself up and said he would continue this mission alone. In reality, it was a suicide mission where he would not escape from there because his leg was injured. He also didn't want to burden Limo and put her life in danger. Howe then advised Limo always to take care of Yuan after his death. With great difficulty dragging his feet, Howe rushed over to the lava volume controller. Before the time bomb exploded, he said goodbye to Yuan through the CCTV camera connected to the control room. Howe's plan worked. The lava volume control device was destroyed and the stored lava spilled out and scorched the roots of the predatory plants. The machine that relaunches the N11 capsule moves. When it goes to the specified depth point, the capsule automatically explodes and sprays a sedative to the roots of the predatory plant, which immediately works effectively to kill the mutated cells in the plant. The surface begins to return to its original form. The entire special forces manage to implant N11 capsules worldwide, and slowly but surely, all the mutated plants have completely returned to normal and human civilization is gradually recovering. The film ends by showing Yuan with the remaining soldiers, along with people worldwide watching the predatory plants slowly return to normal plants. With this disaster, people have become more concerned with efforts to preserve the environment.